Most people think of slavery and child labor as a thing of the past. But unfortunately, some estimates believe there are more slaves than ever before, and the problem with child labor has gotten worse and not better. Now, there was quite a bit of child labor going back into the previous millennium, but the difference for so long was that children worked with their parents, who could carefully shepherd them and pass on a useful trade and make sure they weren't abused. The Industrial Revolution, though, it changed all of that. And the rest, well, that's history. Number 10. The Industrial Revolution reshaped the world with a brutal new form of child labor. The Industrial Revolution paved the way for massive exploitation, low-key slavery, actual slavery, and general outright abuse of workers. Considering children are the most vulnerable, they tended to be the most exploited, especially those who were orphans or came from a large and poor family who desperately needed either money or one less mouth to feed. Before the Industrial Revolution, parents had taught children trades and passed on specialties, but with all the machines and factories and assembly lines, many trades became obsolete and the new jobs simply did not pay as well. This meant families started sending their children to work because they simply had no choice. They could not afford to survive, and the child was a source of income for the family to help feed themselves, if nothing else. This was long before concepts like food stamps or social welfare even existed, and there really weren't any child labor laws to speak of because they hadn't been needed before that. Before long, children were working brutally long shifts for very little pay and were not actually learning any discernibly useful skills. Number 9. Chimney sweeps bought children from poor people and used them as expendable slaves. Chimney sweeps are romanticized in the movie Mary Poppins. Dick Van Dyke talks in a Cockney accent that many British people today find offensive at worst and laughable at best, and has a funny dance routine with other chimney sweeps that makes the whole profession look, well, rather whimsical. However, the reality was is that the life of a chimney sweep was absolutely horrible, and there was very little fun, joy, or any dancing to be had at all. Chimney sweeps had a very dangerous job, and the amount of soot they breathed in gave them all sorts of cancers and illnesses that they didn't even understand back then. But the bleakest part of it all that movie didn't bother to show was all the child slavery. You see, chimney sweeps had a pretty awful job, and they were well aware of it, so many of them felt that they needed to find a way to make it safer. Now, in the modern world, someone would work to invent a safety device or a tool that helps you clean out the chimney without sticking yourself so far down inside it. However, this was back in the old-timey days, and they saw a perfectly evil solution to the whole danger problem. Simply have an expendable pawn do the job for you. Chimney sweeps would literally buy children from poor families who were struggling to feed all their kids and would skirt the laws by putting it down in the books as an apprenticeship. Sadly, with how high mortality rates were, many of them were obviously never going to, or meant to, complete their apprenticeship in the first place. Getting stuck in a chimney flue and suffocating was incredibly common, and a horrible fate that befell many young child slaves that were cleaning chimneys back in the day. Number 8. Newsies did not have as much fun as is depicted on Broadway. For those who don't know, newsies were the kids in big cities back in the day, especially cities like New York, who would hawk newspapers while constantly shouting out the day's news to all within earshot in the hopes to meet the daily quota. Now, we aren't saying that the movie Newsies or the Broadway play made the life of a newsie look like fun and games, but one of the main characters that is a newsie is supposed to be the ripe old age of 17, and there are a lot of charismatic adult actors who take up a lot of screen time. The real life of a newsie would require a very depressing period drama rather than a Disney musical to capture the true reality of the life. Usually orphans, these children would be out on the streets from a very, very young age, hawking newspapers well into the night. They often made only 30 cents a day after putting in an incredible amount of work, and they had to work in all elements, and they couldn't return the papers, so they'd often be seen in saloons or brothels at the worst times of the night, trying to finish their day's work. Most had nowhere to sleep and would often be seen huddling in groups under stairways, trying to find warmth in each other. When they went on strike due to the cost of newspapers rising, it was because they were fighting for their very lives. There were thousands of newsies estimated to be living in New York, and an end to the pitiful livelihood they had could have been a death sentence. They may not have had a formal education, but they were determined. One of the lead strikers, named Kid Blink, had this to say: "Friends and fellow workers, this is a time which tries the hearts of men. This is a time when we's got to stick together like glue. We know what we want, and we'll get it, even if we is blind." While their lives were grim, they stuck together for their rights, because they had no one else who would protect them. Number 7. Child mining during the Industrial Revolution was more horrific than you could even imagine. We've all heard that children were once used to help out in the mines, and we are all relieved that it is no longer something that is allowed. It's a relic of the olden days. However, sadly, the more appropriate context is to consider that most cultures actually didn't force children into coal mines until the Industrial Revolution, and our so-called enlightened modern thinking allowed it to go on for far longer than many of us are comfortable with. Children would be used for all kinds of mining jobs, but typically their days would start at 1 or 2 in the morning and they would work for 12 to 14 hours straight before going back to bed, often underground. It is said that some child miners never really got to see the light of day. Sometimes they would be given horrifically boring jobs where they went down into a cold, dark, lonely pit and simply operated ventilated doors that let people in and out, a job where they would sometimes fall asleep because of the sheer boredom and drudgery. If they fell asleep, though, they would of course be soundly beaten for the infraction. Some children were used because while crawling, they could fit into tight spaces that the adults could not. They would sometimes be harnessed up with chains and ropes and belts in order to pull loads through claustrophobic areas, never getting even close to enough rest, and even less proper ventilation. Number 6. Kids working in factories had to deal with cruel punishments on top of the dangerous work. When the Industrial Revolution started, many children went off to work in factories in order to help support the family, and they often suffered very abusive conditions. However, at least some children who worked in the factories did get to go home to their parents after a day's work and show them that they had managed to earn something. The work, it was dangerous and it was harsh, but these children had it a little bit better. Unfortunately for those children who were orphaned, working in a factory was often the only way to survive, and owners got away with treating children like slaves by legally claiming they were providing room, board, and other needs. The orphaned and enslaved children who lived in the factories they worked at would be awoken very early in the morning and rushed off to the factory floor, sometimes being forced to carry their clothes while naked and dress on the way in order to be sure that they were on time for work. As these children didn't even have parents, the owners gave absolutely zero care towards their safety or well-being, and accidents and fatalities were very common. These children were also the victims of cruel punishments. One of the more awful punishments of the factory foreman was called waiting. A weight would be tied to the victim's neck, and they would have to walk around with the weight on as an example to others. As you can imagine, neck and back injuries were incredibly common from this practice. Number 5. India estimates there are over 1 million child sex slaves in the country. India is a very quickly growing country, and like any country going through such rapid growth, this presents some very big problems. India has issues with waste management, overcrowding in urban areas, a hodgepodge of laws and village councils that are often at odds with each other, a huge mismatch in male to female population, and a gigantic child slavery problem. Indian culture places great value on having a son to carry on the family line, so while parents still love their daughters, they will often keep having children until they have a son. This means there are many more women than there are men in India, making it even easier for there to be many more women and young women who either aren't wanted or don't fully have a place in society, and they can be exploited. In India today, authorities estimate that there may be over 1 million children in the country who are involved in some form of sexual slavery. The Indian government has an enormous task on their hands when it comes to getting a handle on the problem, and with the population the way it is, their task is unlikely to get easier anytime soon. The only upside that the government faces in tackling this problem is that rarely these children are trafficked out of the country. Number 4. Chocolate farming child slaves tricked with a promise of bicycle, but beaten with a chain instead. Chocolate farming is something that most of us have heard at least a few things about the horrors of, but we try our best to not think about it. A child slave who toiled in the Ivory Coast was once interviewed about his work, and he said that he had not ever gotten to even try chocolate. But as far as he was concerned, people who enjoyed eating chocolate were metaphorically eating his flesh. Many horror stories have emerged, and they show the depths and depravity that slavers will sink to in order to increase productivity. One child slave was initially tricked into thinking he would work hard and get both a bicycle and get money to send back to his family. Instead, he did not get any money, and instead of the bike, he was beaten with the bike's chain whenever he did not perform well. The companies that buy the chocolate from these farmers, they have enough financial leverage to institute fair labor practices if they really wanted to. Or if they couldn't do it directly, they could force the governments to take action. However, despite international pressure, the chocolate companies, they keep laying down deadlines for themselves to force improvements and then just blowing right past said deadlines. The truth is that business is amoral and exists to make a profit. If we want the chocolate companies to change, we have to apply consumer pressure. They have no reason to spend millions on something that isn't negatively affecting their balance sheets. Number 3. Child labor on US farms is common and leads to numerous fatalities and injuries. Most people think of child labor in the USA as a thing very much in the past. All children must attend school and they cannot drop out until they are at least 16 in most situations, and the earliest kids can work is maybe 15 with a great deal of restrictions and controls. While this is true in almost all industries, farming is the one business in the United States where you can still get your fill of child labor. Farmers simply have trouble finding enough workers, even if they're offering good pay, so the government allows farmers to have kids work on the farm. The children still have to learn stuff like reading and writing, but they are usually homeschooled. Now, the education's not really the problem here. It's more to do with the kind of labor. The sort of labor we're talking about here is the sort of labor we'd see prior to the Industrial Revolution, a parent carefully taking care of their child with a watchful eye and showing them an entirely new trade. This is something that is likely to be useful to them as an adult. Their parents are passing down skills that they can use later in life, even if they decided that running a farm wasn't for them. The problem is, though, that farming equipment can be extremely dangerous, and the children just don't have the skills that they need to use it. Children are even allowed to drive to a certain extent without a license on farms, and this helps lead to a lot of the injuries. Roughly 100 children die every year due to accidents with farm equipment, and thousands more are injured. Number 2. Children as young as 4 in Pakistan are kidnapped and sold to be camel jockeys. The Middle East may be known for things like harems or child marriages and such, but there is another non-sexual form of slavery that is also extremely horrifying and has been picking up steam despite official efforts to ban it. Especially in the UAE, there is a camel racing circuit replete with all kinds of sleaze that you would expect from old-timey horse racing in the US. Now, just racing camels wouldn't have been an issue, but they decided that adults were simply too heavy and they wanted the camels to go faster and faster. Increasingly smaller children were used until the government banned riders under the age of 14 in 1998. Despite this, though, the practice is still going strong. It is estimated that roughly 2,000 children were kidnapped from neighboring Pakistan over the course of a 2-year period and sold to be trained as jockeys. Now, alone this would not seem like the worst type of child labor, but the problem is these children were used because they had reduced weights, so the practice has become increasingly cruel. Many children are being kidnapped as young as 4 and are being introduced to the sport before they even know what it is. The children are allowed almost nothing to eat, so they will be lighter, and that makes the camel faster. They are often whipped if they do something wrong or do not perform well enough. Inventors have been working on robotic camel jockeys that are slowly picking up steam in the country. Some experts hope that if these robots are eventually light enough, the need for child jockeys will be completely phased out, and so even the morally bankrupt won't use them. Number 1. Child labor is actually on the rise all around the world, even in the USA. The unfortunate fact is that child labor is nearly always some form of child slavery, even if other clever names are used to disguise that fact. Now, most people comfort themselves with the knowledge that even if we have more slaves than ever before, it must be because the world's population has increased or something like that. Most people tend to assume, at the very least, that our efforts around the world are bringing down the amount of child labor considerably and making the world a safer place with less suffering and less sadness. Sadly, however, we're in a much worse place than we would like to believe. The entire world may have to redouble their efforts to fight child slavery because it's going up everywhere. Maplecroft, a global risk assessment firm, came out with a report in 2012 stating that they had seen a 10% increase in countries where labor practices ingrained in the laws and culture posed a very serious risk to children's safety and development. Worse yet, even in the United States, which many still think of as a safe haven from most of these abuses, is still listed as medium risk. If we all want to combat child labor around the globe, we are going to have to make more of an effort. Perhaps labeling it appropriately as what it really is, child slavery. So I'm not going to ask if you found that video enjoyable, but I do hope you found it interesting and maybe it opened your eyes to the problem that exists. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe for more videos every day of the week. Also linking over to some other videos that we've done on the screen now. And as always, thank you for watching.